Chapter 2. From the castle, the Pendips rolled and crashed for some miles, past rippling becks and chuckling gutters, along forest paths and wooded glades, down the rugged rock towers to the dark walls of Castle Blackheart. Within the mighty escarpments, the Baron and his wife sat in the great hall contemplating their Christmas.
"But it's just not complete," said the Baroness. "Life is empty and drab, and, well, I feel I failed you."
"You mustn't worry about it. What's meant to be will be."
"But an heir is everything. There's no point to life without one. I have to succeed at this basic part of life."
"Don't be hard on yourself. There's more to life than that."
"But the king's got an heir. Why can't we?"
"Well, we should just be happy for them."
"I can't. It's all too tragic."
A strange look shadowed her face as she gazed at the crackling fire.
"I have to give you an heir. I simply have to."
"Don't worry about it. It'll happen when it's meant to,"
the Baron said calmly. But the Baroness wasn't listening. She was lost in a cloud of her own thoughts, her gaze and her mood darkening.
"You shall have an heir," she said quietly. "You shall have an heir."
As Christmas Day dawned, her mood seemed to have brightened. She called Wister, the court magician, to her private chambers after the Baron had gone downstairs for breakfast. He entered the room bowing.
"You are to help me,"
the Baroness commanded.
"Yes, my lady?"
"Yes, Wister. The Baron is to organize a joust, a friendly affair between ours and the king's household. We'll invite a few others to make it all the more believable. There, you will cast a spell on the Princess Abigail, the king's daughter. At my command, there will be..."
The Baroness lowered her voice.
"Well, shall we call it an accident?"
"An accident, madam?"
boomed Wister.
"Whisper, Wister."
"Just Wister, madam."
"What?"
"My name is Wister, not Whisper, Wister."
"Don't be stupid. I want you to whisper."
"Oh, I see."
He coughed and lowered his voice.
"An accident?"
"Yes, an accident, Wister. The princess will appear to be dead. That's what the spell will do. And after she's been placed in her coffin..."
She lowered her voice even more.
"We shall steal the body. We'll have to put something else in the coffin. Then we'll bring the baby here."
Her voice rose slightly in excitement.
"And you will reverse the spell and bring her back to life."
"Quite a challenge, madam. Quite a challenge."
"Can you do it?"
"When I was a child, I used to have a little spell that would make my hamster play dead. I could try a beefed-up version of that one, I suppose."
"Were you ever a child, Wister?"
"Many hundreds of years ago, madam. Yes."
"There's one other thing."
"Yes, madam?"
"You'll have to disguise the girl. Make her look like someone else."
"That will take some time, madam."
"Never mind that. Just do it, Wister."
"Yes, madam."
Later that day, the Baroness approached her husband.
"We must organize a joust with the king's household,"
she told him.
"Why, dear?"
"Well, it's our turn. They organized it last time."
"In the summer, I suppose it might be quite fun, but..."
"No, we should do it now,"
she interrupted.
"In fact, New Year's Day would be a good time."
"But no one jousts in the winter."
"The Greeks did. We could call them the winter, Olympics.
"Well, if it would make you happy, my dear."
"It would."
"I suppose I could give that new knight of mine, Sir Longsword, a tryout."
The Baroness smiled to herself as the elements of her plan fell into place. Back in the king's household, it was the day after Boxing Day, and the king was getting very bored.
"We've had a rather silly invitation from the Blackhearts, my dear,"
said the king.
"Oh, what sort of silly invitation?"
"A joust on New Year's Day, to be held at Castle Blackheart. Everyone will be there, the Glenfiddichs, the Bells, the Knockandos, even the Laguvelins."
"Will the Grouse family be there?" asked the queen.
"Yes, I think so."
"Well, they're so nice. I think we should go. It sounds like fun."
"Oh, do you think so?"
The king seemed less than keen.
"Yes, it can be Abigail's first joust."
The queen sounded enthusiastic.
"Hmm,
the king thought aloud.
She could ride in my arms,
he said, his eyes sparkling. Well, I'm not sure about that. It might be dangerous.
Nonsense,
said the king.
She'll love it. Besides, they've got that new knight, Sir Long Lance or something. I think you're right. We should go.